So this trucker shows up with the biggest truck I've ever seen right here. He didn't call or anything. He just opened up the side of the truck and showed me two big crates, and he said, I'm not joking, do you have a forklift? No, I don't have a forklift. So to give you a bit of perspective, this really nice lady reached out to me a little less than a year ago and asked me if I wanted to try a laser from their company. And stupid as I am sometimes, I said yes without thinking it through, because I don't even know what to use a laser for. But as it turns out, I did have a forklift, that is, or not really. But we have a half-broken fork attachment for the tractor. So that's how the crates ended up in here eventually. But now I need to take the crates down to the barn where I'll actually have the laser in the workshop. It's a luxury problem to have, I know. But what could you actually do with a laser? If you're anything like me, you might have felt this feeling of agreeing to things you really don't want to do and then regret it. But you're too scared to go back on your promise. Now, I realize that I sound like the most spoiled YouTuber right now. Oh, I was given a laser and I don't know what to use it for. Yeah, I might just be the most spoiled YouTuber, but the thing is, it's a bit overwhelming sometimes when you take on too much work and you see the mountain of things you need to do in front of you. I should say though, I wasn't given this laser for free. It's a business transaction where I put in a lot of work and in return the company gets marketing of their product. I would also argue that all the work I've already put in to YouTube has led me to receiving this laser. Anyways, I can live with the fact that I'm a spoiled YouTuber. I still don't know what to use it for. It's still work I didn't want to do. I'm mostly used to 3D printers where I get to build stuff up from the ground. I'm not used to cutting stuff out as much, and I guess that's what I'll be using the laser for, or engraving things. But to justify buying a machine like this, you would have some product in mind, I guess. So I need to come up with the product now, after receiving the machine. A product that can be laser cut or engraved, and that would give me some return. So the crates are in place, and no, this barn is not insulated yet, but the goal is to have that ready for the winter. Apparently there's water cooling in this monster, so I need to figure that out, because if the water starts freezing and expanding, it could potentially ruin the entire machine. So I guess what remains for me now is to unpack it. So here's the plan. Unbox the laser, learn how to use the thing, test its limits, so to speak, and figure out what to use it for. I guess I'll start with this box because I think the laser's in that one, and in this one it should be the table for it. So there I was, unboxing what I wasn't really sure I would use it for, but of course a machine of great potential. I guess it's like buying an air fryer or something. You know, that if you use it right, you could create something really good. You just have to learn it. But if you want to create something extraordinary, you need to be creative with it. Come up with your own recipe. And I figured that if I could just get this thing running and trying out the potential, it might lead me to potentially create something extraordinary. And learning from past experience, it's just a matter of digging deep into something. By the way, searching the internet for laser projects offers no help at all. People make some pretty dumb and ugly things with lasers. And even worse, people buy the dumb and ugly things. But I didn't get a laser to make coasters. And no, I'm not making tumblers either. I mean, I might try them out, but I'm not making them and selling them. It's like with most tools, I guess. The tools can be great, but what are you gonna make with it? They did not save money on the packing, that's for sure. Extremely well packed. Almost all sides gone. And yes, it does. There we have some boxes. Now, this wasn't the first laser company to ever reach out to me. But when I saw that this was from Aeon, that was the reason I accepted it. Because from what I've learned, if you want a really good laser, Aeon is the place to go. Now, this is a CO2 laser, which means... Hang on, I'll explain it like I'm five. Here's how it works. Inside the laser, there's a special mix of gases, mainly carbon dioxide along with some nitrogen and helium. When we turn the laser on, electricity flows through the gas mix. The electricity makes the gas molecules get very excited and start bouncing around. These excited gas molecules release energy in the form of light. This light bounces back and forth inside the laser, getting stronger and stronger. Finally, this strong light shoots out of the laser as a powerful and precise beam. This beam can be used to cut through materials like wood, metal, and plastic, or even do delicate surgeries, because it's super precise and can be controlled very carefully. It's like having a magical light sword that you can do all sorts of amazing things with. But without ideas, it can't do anything. This particular one is 80 watt, which means it should be able to cut some seriously thick materials. But what is also cool with this one is that it's got a pass-through, so I could literally do longer materials than what the laser bed have room for. I'll have to try that. Alongside that, this one is called the Mira 7S. The S stands for the Red Line series, and this machine packs some cool features for a laser. It's got autofocus, it's got a camera, works with light burn, which in my mind is the only sensible option out there. It's got a built-in compressor and a water cooler. For now, I was standing there with a really good laser in a barn without a single idea of what to use it for. But if it's one thing I take pride in, it's coming up with ideas, so I wasn't gonna give up that easily. You need to look for problems to solve to come up with ideas, so that's what I did. Also, I did have a master plan. A really good friend of mine and the other half of the podcast, Three Northern Makers, Steve Bell Creates, well, I'm the first half of the podcast if that wasn't clear, he's a laser genius, so I figured if I just shoot him a message, he can probably help me coming up with ideas.
Hey man.
Hi Pierre.
I'm just getting my laser installed and I'm in need of ideas for projects to make with it. Do you have any ideas?
Very cool. Why don't you try and come up with your own ideas instead of trying to steal mine all the time? See you later. Sally, can you come and help me come up with an idea for a project?
What?
Okay, so he wasn't up for it. Well, what about a backup plan? I'll just look on Pinterest. Is this what they call doom scrolling? Because there's nothing here I want to make. What about leather? It should be really easy to make a leather item. Let's try that out. I spent some time drawing up a wallet design I like, and then I realized I could also use the laser to engrave the leather.
This is actually really cool because I just throw my design in light burn and the camera up here helps me align the pieces perfectly so I don't waste a bunch of material. And then I just press play and it does its thing. It's pretty awesome.
So I kind of fell back in love with leather and started making all sorts of projects with it. And cutting leather with the laser is easy. It's not totally without errors. You need to clean the leather a bit after cutting, but still, really good. At that point, I was really feeling it. I thought that this was the thing. This was the extraordinary thing to make, leather items. Then I of course had to go through the parts the laser can't do, sewing, burnishing, and all that other stuff. But in the end, I had a pretty nice looking wallet and some card holders. I even engraved some aluminium business cards to put inside of them. But it wasn't extraordinary. It was just a leather wallet and a card holder. But if you're a leather maker with a laser like this, you're golden. I mean, you can batch out a lot of stuff that otherwise would take a lot longer. I made a couple of them. But it wasn't extraordinary, so I kept on looking for something else to make.
See, what I find really fascinating about this is what used to only be available for like factories to make is now available to us, every one of us. We can make it at home. I just think we gotta keep it down so we don't produce crap for the sake of just making. Like, the world doesn't need more lasered coasters. Just let there be some rings on the table. It's patina, soul.
If there's one thing this laser does well though, it's signs. So whilst I was playing around, I figured I could at least make a sign. And I had this ceiling LED panel. So I thought if I covered the LED with an acrylic, that would probably look cool. So I threw a piece of acrylic on the laser and had it cut my logo. I didn't want the frame of the LED to show, so I made a wooden frame for it with more manual tools than the laser. I already knew this wasn't it, but at least making something would lead me to new ideas that could lead me to the extraordinary. The frame is a very basic frame, made with Velcro mat and finished with Rubio Monocoat All Plus 2C Pure. I placed the acrylic in the frame and then the LED on top of that, and I just attached it with some screws and a French cleat to be able to hang it on the wall. I mean, it looks pretty cool and I'll keep this in my new workshop, but it isn't extraordinary, is it? What about cutting wood? Well, I did try that out, and whilst it can cut wood, it's not what this machine is made for, I suppose. But it could do it. The thinner, the better, and cutting out templates for woodworking, it's perfect for that. I did cut some stuff out, but none of it I found useful. And that's basically the opposite of what I hoped to use the laser for. Like, some things might look like good ideas, but who needs a tank for storing 3 cans of beer and a bottle? No one. I mean, this candle holder, won't it just burn? It's wood. I'll try it out. I suppose it won't, but we don't need these, do we? Okay, I didn't sand it, but it doesn't look nice, does it? You could say I made it. Yeah, I did, but only to show you that you shouldn't. All right.
Also, there are websites that can make boxes for you to laser cut. You can just put in the dimensions and your kerf, download the SVG and have it cut on the laser, and you have a box. Perhaps cut some EVA foam and place something inside of the box. Perhaps engrave a logo on top of the box. I can't tell you how tired I am of seeing these plywood boxes being made, like they are a great thing you can make with a laser. But anyways, it can do it. And yes, I did a really lazy job. I couldn't be bothered to connect the compressor. Whilst the laser has its own compressor, you can also attach an external one when cutting wood. I also couldn't be bothered sanding or finishing the walnut veneered plywood. The EVA foam I placed inside of the box, and I guess you could make boxes like this, but it's not extraordinary at all. I also engraved some cork coasters, just to try it out. But here's the thing, maybe this is just me, and in that case let me know, but people who put coasters on their table, it feels like a bit of a particular type of person. Just don't be a jerk. I also received a rotary with the machine, so I had to try to use it, and I know, everyone makes tumblers, so it's nothing new. But I figured I should at least try, and maybe that will spark an idea for something extraordinary. I didn't get the settings all dialed in, but these Japanese tumblers look kind of cool. But they're not extraordinary. They might be a way of earning some income, as well as the leather items, but not extraordinary. I also tried batch producing. Everything's new to me, so finding the correct settings takes a bit longer. But if you want to earn money on the laser, you probably want to batch produce. I engraved some of my limited edition folding rulers. It's easy enough making a jig and then just batch them out. I also wondered why I didn't cut the jig the other way. I don't know. Human error. And then as I was packing up, I realized there was actually a problem I needed to solve. I just celebrated myself by gifting myself an iPad. Yeah, I know.
I didn't have a case for it though, because I really don't like those fold-over lids that cover the screen. It's just as bad as the cover we buy to cover up a perfectly good-looking phone. When I'm using it, there's no real issue with me dropping it. It's only when I'm not using it that it needs protection. So I immediately started drawing up a prototype case for the iPad. I had the leather cut on the laser, duh, and then started working on sewing it together. I added felt to the inside, which I also had cut on the laser. Of course, come on, keep up. And then I just had everything put together. I even added some magnetic clasps to it and covered them up on the inside with felt because I realized it too late. They could have been in between the felt and the leather to start with, but this was a prototype. And this has some flaws I need to solve for version 2, but look at it. It's not that bad, is it? I mean, is it extraordinary? I don't know. I don't know what to say, but man, am I proud. When I try to get inspiration for the laser and I search the internet for inspiration, most of the stuff you'll see is just laser cut plywood. And I don't think it gives the correct idea of what a laser actually is. I don't think that's the main thing to use it for. So to me, that just looks like a bad representation of what a laser actually is. Like this cheap coaster set. It's okay to make, don't get me wrong, but it's just something extra. No one in the world needs these. And it's not funny either. If I came home to someone with that coaster set, I would be like, ha ha.
In the end, I looked at the collection of things I had made and thought to myself, none of these things individually are extraordinary. But when I saw them together, I realized that it wasn't the items in themselves, but the machine that was extraordinary. Because one machine was capable of doing all of these things. And it's not to say you would need one, because I don't think you do, but it's a pretty powerful thing that can make all sorts of things. You know what? I think I am just spoiled. I expect more of tools and more of myself all the time. Sometimes I think I need to realize that a machine that can cut all kinds of materials and engrave them is really cool. And I've been just touching the surface here. There's so much more we can use this machine for that I haven't tried yet. A laser isn't for everyone, but for me, this will be the start of many cool things. I'm glad I told that nice lady I would accept the laser now that I've tried it.